Hello students, today we are going to learn a new topic, that is reaction in solution and expressing their concentration. Most of the chemical reaction in laboratory are carried out in solution. So we must know about the different ways in which the amount of substance in a solution are expressed. The concentration of the binary solution in which two components, that is solute and solvent, are present in number of ways. That is, we have binary solution. Binary solution means it has two components. One is solute, other is solvent. So these are the two components that is consists of binary solution. So there are number of, as I told, there are number of ways to express this their concentration. Okay, now first is strength. First is strength, then second is mass percent. Third is volume percent. Fourth is ppm. Fifth is molarity. Then molality. Then we have normality. And also mole fraction. So let us go one by one. That is, I will take first strength. What is strength? Okay. So students, strength of a solution is defined as the amount of solute in grams present in 1 liter or 1 liter or 1 decimeter cube of the solution. So strength is defined as the amount of solute in grams dissolved amount of solute in grams dissolved in or decimeter cube of the solution. So its unit is we can say gram per liter or gram liter inverse, or I can say gram decimeter cube. Okay, so now let us see a question. That is, for example, if 4 grams of a solute, is dissolved in 250 ml of the solution. So what will be the strength? So we have to find the strength. So if 4 grams of the solute is dissolved in 250 ml of the solution, so strength can be, as I said, strength is, that is 4 gram divided by 250 ml. So we will convert it into liter. So it comes to be 4 into 1000 divided by 250. So that means we got 16 gram liter inverse, or gram decimeter cube, or gram decimeter cube. So in this way we can calculate the given strength of the solution. So our next topic is mass percent. So mass percent of a solution is defined as the number of parts by mass of one component, that is solute or solvent, per 100 parts of mass of the solution. So what is mass percent? Mass percent of the solution is defined as number of parts by mass of one component, it can be solute or solvent, per 100 parts by mass of the solution. So when I say mass percent, and we are dealing with only primary binary compound, so solute and solvent will be there. So if one is 60%, the other will be 40%. So suppose if I take two component, A and B are the two component, then mass percent of A, it can be given as with the alphabet, that is WA by WA plus WB into 100. So this is mass percent. So in this way we can calculate the mass percent. Okay, our next topic is that is volume percent. So I will just change the mass by volume. So volume percent, the number of parts by volume. Next is the number of parts by volume of one component, solute or solvent, per 100 parts by volume. Of the solution. So in place of mass, I am again removing this. So volume percent of A is, that is volume of A, I can write in this way, that is VA by VA plus VB into 100. So this is the volume percent of A. Similarly, we can write the volume percent of B also. So it will be VB by VA plus VB into 100. Is it clear? So in continuation with that, that is now we can, we'll see mass volume percent. So mass volume percent, the number of parts by mass of one component to the volume of the solution. Okay, the number of parts by mass of one component to the volume of the solution. So if we can, if we have to write, that is mass volume percent is equal to, you can write WA by VA plus VB into 100. So this will give you the mass volume percent. So if a question is asked, that is in if there is a question that is 10% of KCl solution, that is mass by volume, in mass by volume, in this way. So this means that is 10 gram This means 10 gram of the solute, 10 grams of the solute is dissolved in 100 ml or 0.1 liter of the solution. So 10% of KCl solution m by v, this means 10 grams of the solute is dissolved in 100 ml of the solution or 0.1 liter of the solution. So this question is there, that is, a solution has been prepared by dissolving 5 grams of urea in 95 grams of water. What is the mass percent of the mass percent of urea in the solution? So for mass percent of urea, you can solve this question as the mass percent of urea is equal, that is, mass of the solute by mass of the solution into 100. So mass of the solute, here solute is urea, so 5 grams, so I'll put 5 gram divided by mass of the solution. We have 5 grams plus 95 gram, so that will be 5 plus 95 into 100, so it will be 5%. So 5%, the mass percent of urea is 5%. So students, mass percent and the volume percent are simply ratios. They don't have any units. Okay. So our next topic is parts per million. For a dilute solution in which a very small amount of solute is added or dissolved in large excess of the solvent, at that time we will be using what? PPM, that is parts per million. So 1 million, that is 10 to the power 6. Okay. So the number of parts by mass, so I can write parts per million in small letter PPM. So the number of or volume of one component of per million parts of the So the parts per million, it can be written as PPMA is equal to, that means mass of A divided by mass of the solution. Into 10 to the power 6. Similarly, volume of A divided by volume of the solution into 10 to the power 6. So for very small amount of the solute is dissolved in large excess amount of the solvent. So parts per million is being used. So students, we have a question based on the PPM. So question is, 1 liter of seawater weighs 1050 grams and contains 6 × 10⁻³ grams of dissolved oxygen gas. Calculate the concentration of the dissolved gas in PPM. So here the mass of the oxygen is given as that is 6 × 10⁻³, and mass of the seawater is given as 1050 gram. So I'll write mass of oxygen O2 is equal to 6 × 10⁻³ grams. Mass of seawater 1050 gram. So PPM, that is parts per million of oxygen, is equal to mass of divided by mass of seawater into 10⁶. Okay, now which we have the values, we will put that is 6 × 10⁻³ into 10⁶ by 1050 gram. 1050 gram. So after calculating, it comes to be 5.71 ppm. So the degree of hardness of water is normally expressed in ppm. Okay, so now next topic is our molarity. Molarity of a solution may be defined as the number of moles of gram moles of the solute dissolved in per liter or decimeter cube of the solution. Molarity can be written as gram moles of solute by volume of the solution in liter. Gram moles of solute divided by volume of the solution in liter or decimeter cube. Okay, it can be further written as, you know, this gram moles of solute, we can write as mass of the solute divided by molar mass, then if the volume is given in ml, so we will be making it, we will convert it into that is liter. So volume of the solution in, if it is in ml, so divided by 1000. Okay, and the unit for molarity is mole liter inverse, or gram moles per liter, or I can write gram moles per liter. Okay, now we will take a example of molarity. That is molarity of a solution containing 4.9 grams of H2SO4 dissolved in 250 ml of the solution can be calculated as, I said 4.9 grams of H2SO4 dissolved in 250 ml. Okay, now, so we know molarity is equal to, that is given mass, yeah, mass of the solute by molar mass divided by volume of the solution in liter. So here the mass is 4.9 gram. Now molar mass of H2SO4, that is, so molar mass of H2SO4, 2H plus S plus 4 into O. So 2 into 1 plus 32 plus 4 into 16. That is 64 plus 32 plus 2, which comes to be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is 98 gram per mole. Okay, so 98 gram per mole, I'll put here, that is 98 gram mole inverse divided by, now it is in ml, so we have to make it in liter. So 250 divided by 1000. So we have converted it into now liter. So after solving this, we have, that is 0.5 divided by 0.25 liter. Here it comes to be, that is 0.2 m. okay, so I can write, or I can write mole, 0.2 mole liter inverse. Okay, so molarity of the solution on mixing two solution containing the same solute. Here the question is, what is the molarity of the resulting solution obtaining by mixing 2.5 liter of 0.5 m of urea and 500 ml of 2 m urea solution. So for that we have a molarity of mixing solution. We can write a formula, that is molarity of solution on mixing is equal to, that is m1 v1 plus m2 v2 is equal to m3 v1 plus v2. Okay, so this is, suppose this is the molarity, same solute as sold, as I told, same, we have to take the same solute. So here the solute is urea. Okay, so here first the molarity is 0.5 m into volume is 2.5 liter, plus next again the volume is that is solid, the molarity is 2 m into, it will be 0.5, so which will be 0.5, that means the answer comes to be 2.25 divided by 3. Okay, so which is equal to 0.75 m. So our next topic is molality. Molality is given by the small m, that is molality of a solution is defined as the number of moles or gram moles of the solute dissolved in 1000 grams of the solvent. So molality is gram moles of solute dissolved in mass of solvent. So I can write that is mass of solute by molar mass, then mass of solvent, it will be in kg, mass of solvent in grams divided by 1000. So if in grams, it will be in 1000. Okay, so it will be in 1000. So the unit will be, that is gram moles per kg, unit will be gram moles पर केजी और ग्राम मोल और मोल केजी इनवर्स. ओके, सो द मोलैरिटी ऑफ ए सोल्यूशन कंटेनिंग 5.3 ग्राम्स ऑफ एनहाइड्रस Na2CO3 इन 200 ग्राम्स ऑफ वाटर. सो मोलैरिटी कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड एज मोलैरिटी, व्हाट इज द मास ऑफ द सोल्यूट इज गिवन एज 5.3 ग्राम एंड मोलर मास ऑफ Na2CO3 इज 106 डिवाइडेड बाय इट इज गिवन इन 200 ग्राम्स. So I'll make it in kg 1000. So after calculating 0.05 0.2, it will be 0.2. So the answer will be, it is in mole and it is in kg, so 0.25 m. Okay, so students, today we have learned some of the concentration term. In the next class, we will deal with the other terms, and keep practicing for this concentration terms nicely in your home. Thank you very much.